Hello, and welcome to 5-Minute Math. Today we are looking at the third grade concept of representing addition and subtraction problems. This is standard 3.5A in the great state of Texas. We're using the first problem off the 2017 released STAAR test. If you have not done so already, please go ahead and take a moment to pause the video, work this problem out on your own, and then unpause it. We will look at our answers together. So we have an art teacher, and an art teacher's got some problems with some crayons. We've got three numbers here, 736, 197, 150. And if you notice, all of our answer selections have those three numbers in the exact same order. The only thing we need to figure out is which equation is correct, because you notice sometimes they start with subtraction, sometimes they end with addition, and then all of them have a second operation. So this is a two-step problem, or sometimes called a multi-step problem. So we need to figure out which operation do we do first and which operation do we do second. So there's two ways to do this. First, we're going to try to just make sense of the story ourselves and solve the problem and see if we can find one that matches. And then what we're going to do is we're going to, just to verify, we're going to actually do some of this math, because these are just addition subtraction problems, and see which one of those just double checks with the one we think is correct. So we have an art teacher. And let's just put 736 up here. I'm just going to put a big box, like it's my starting total. So that's how many crayons we're going to have. And so the only thing here is we've got two terms, threw away and bought. And so the tricky thing here in third grade is you have to know, well, when you throw something away, are you adding or subtracting? When you're buying something, are you adding or subtracting? That's all this type of problem is wanting you to figure out. In a real world situation, you need to know that when you throw something away, you are subtracting it. So we are going to subtract 197 crayons. If they're broken, we don't want them. So let's go ahead and just do that real quick. So we're going to have to regroup twice. We don't necessarily have to. As you can see, we're not looking for the actual answer, but it'd be good just to know. So 16 minus 7 is 9. 2 minus 9, can't do that. We need to regroup. So let's do 12 minus 9 is 3. So she's got 539 left after throwing away that 197. So what are we going to do? We're going to buy 150. So when you buy something, you add. And so that's really the trick of this problem, is you need to know that when you throw something away, you're going to subtract. When you buy something, you add it. Another clue on when you're buying something is more. So when you're buying more, that means you're adding to it. And typically we throw away things that are broken. And that means we're going to subtract them. We don't want them anymore. So we've got a few clues there. So we're going to add the 150 and let's see how many we have. So not even any regrouping necessary here. 689. And so here's our second check. So it looks like we subtracted first and added second. So it looks like it's probably going to be B. But what we can do is we can just, to double check, since there is no 689 anywhere, we can just look to see what happens on the rest of these. So on A, we've got 736. We're going to subtract the 197. We already did that. That's going to be 539. But look what they did. They subtracted seconds. Well, when you buy more crayons, you're not going to subtract. You're actually going to add. So this is going to give us a number that's much too small. And it's only going to give us 389. So we went in the wrong direction. So that is incorrect. Now C and D, they both add. 736, and I'm just going to do both of these together. 736 and 197. So they both add, but that doesn't obviously make any sense, because when you're throwing away broken crayons, you're not adding, you're subtracting. So that's going to be 13. That's going to be another 13. That's 933. And then the only difference is on C, you're adding the 150. So you're just adding everything. Well, you are buying the extra, but look at now you ended up with 1,083 crayons. You should have ended up with 689. And then on D, we are subtracting the 150, so what we actually did was both of these operations are completely wrong. We added when we should have subtracted, we subtracted when we should have added, and you get something that's kind of close, 783, but still not the right answer, which is B.